Let's see. You have any new times? Just like 4 days ago, we posted this little video where I actually kind of explain a little more about how Jesus offers for us to be his bride. because I always thought that was really weird, but as you read through the Old Testament, you actually see God doesn't just call us friends, he just doesn't just call us children, but he actually calls us his bride, right? Which is weird as a guy. Girls, you're like, yes, my Jesus. Guys, you're like, I'm having trouble with the analogy. You know when Jesus, can I share like 2 minutes with you guys really quick, and then I'll do one last song. At the Last Supper, it's crazy she had a cup too. Because you know at the Passover feast where Jesus is hanging with the disciples, and he says those, you know, famous words, this is my covenant, take and drink it. Well, scholars say that was probably the third cup of the feast that Jesus took that and said that with. And it was known as the cup of salvation. And typically a rabbi wouldn't drink that. He would take it and pour it and he'd set it aside, like saying, hey, this is the rabbi, the Messiah is coming and it's not me. But Jesus takes that cup, and when he drinks it, he's saying, dude, the Messiah is here. He's now. And then when he says, this is my covenant, take and drink it, to us, we just hear Eucharist. We just hear Passover. We hear Last Supper. We hear communion. But to those fishermen at that time, they heard, will you marry me? Because in those days, this is crazy. In those days, when a guy was going to propose to a girl, this is how it would go. He'd see a girl, right? He'd be like, I'll make some little rabbis with her, you know what I'm saying? So he'd go to his dad, he'd go, yo, dad, yo, hook me up. I need to get a conversation with her, you know what I'm saying? Oh, he's like, all right, I'll go talk to her dad and we'll negotiate a bride price. And so her dad would be like, okay, I like 50 camels and 2 donkeys and it kind of sounds like that guy from Star Wars. Paul the Razor, okay, I don't know why. So they would negotiate a price, right? But it wasn't terribly unromantic. You see, now in the Middle East, the dad of the bride is like paying a groom to get her off his hands. Wow. But in that culture, it was actually the opposite. The groom had to buy a chance to ask her. He didn't even get to buy her outright. He had to buy the chance to ask her. It's kind of like forking up the dough for a date, you know what I'm saying? And so this is what would happen. After they negotiate a price, they would meet in a room with all of their relatives watching. Talk about pressure, right? And then the guy would take a cup and he'd fill it with wine and he'd slide it across the table and he'd say, this is my covenant with you, take and drink it. At which point she could be like, nah, you stank, man. I don't want to do that. And she could say no. But if she said yes, you know how she said yes? She took that cup and she brought it up to her mouth and she drank it. At which point, this is where it gets crazy town. She would go home to her town and people wouldn't call her by her name anymore. She would be referred to as one who was bought with a price. In the meantime, the groom would go back to his dad's house and he'd start building a mansion. Ladies, before you get excited, the word mansion in Hebrew actually means apartment, okay? And to top it off, in the Hebrew culture, it was actually an apartment extension off of the groom's dad's house, okay? It was called an insula. You'd be moving in with the in-laws. Some of you guys are like, please don't let me marry an Israeli boy. And he would start working on that. In the meantime, they wouldn't talk their whole engagement period. They wouldn't even communicate, except the best man. He would bring messages like, check yes, no, or maybe, and he'd run over to her, and he'd come back to his town. And that was the only way they were allowed to talk or see each other. And this is crazy. He's working on the mansion. He didn't even get to decide when it was done. He had to wait on his father's approval to say, all right, it's finished. You can go get her. And once his father said it's finished, he would go get his groomsmen, right? And they'd go marching over into her town unannounced. She wouldn't know the day, the time, or the hour. She'd just be like, I can't wait to get my rabbi Jewish wedding on. And he would come in unannounced with his groomsmen. They would blow some shofars, just like a little ram's horn. And he'd waltz in, and basically she'd walk down the steps, oh my goodness, and down the aisle and get married, okay? Does this sound familiar to anyone? Jesus says, this is my covenant with you, take and drink it. At which point he goes, hey, I gotta leave. During this engagement time, you're not gonna see me, but don't sweat it. I'm gonna send my best man, the Holy Spirit. and he's going to communicate messages between me and you. Now you keep watch, because you're not going to know the day, the time, or the hour. But in the meantime, I'm going home to my father's house, where there are many mansions, and I'm going to prepare one for you. I don't even know the day, the time, or the hour. Only the Father knows. And when he comes and says the mansion is finished, I'm going to go get my posse, my groomsmen, the holy angels. They're going to blow their shofars, the four trumpets, and you're going to come down, and we're going to have the marriage supper of the Lamb. And the thing that's most insane about all that is he extends that cup. And in Isaiah, and in Ezekiel, and in Hosea, he tells us he's not extending that cup to a pure, spotless bride. But he's opening up that invitation to an adulterous, wayward bride. And in Ezekiel 16, he says, I will marry you, and then you'll go and run after other lovers. But nevertheless, I will keep my covenant with you. And so, do you know why Jesus says, I hate divorce? It's not to make divorced people feel bad. He says, I hate divorce because marriage is supposed to display the way that he loves us. And he will never divorce us once we've said yes to him. And so he says, stop getting divorced because you make me look bad. You make people think that I'll divorce you. And I will never divorce my bride. Never divorce you. So I'm going to ask Brendan to come up here and play some piano with me, and I want to do one more song for you guys. Woo! The song's called Beloved.
Oh,
not done playing yet. Are you guys okay if we did one more?
Oh my gosh!
We're probably like way over our time limit, but nobody's kicked us off yet. You guys come up. I'm just kidding. We're done. You say let it go. Control. You say you will be everything I need. You say if I lose my life, it's then I'll find my soul. One more time. You say let it go. You say let it go. You say life is waiting for the ones who lose control. Soul. You say let it go. Thanks guys, have a great day.